We have 8 people seated around a circular table. Each one has a fair coin. They're all going to flip their coins, and those that flip heads will stand up, and those that flip tails will remain seated. We want the probability that no 2 adjacent people will stand. Sounds like my kind of party. Now we're going to start off by counting the number of possible outcomes. That's pretty easy. We have 8 coins, 2 equally likely outcomes for each. 2 to the 8th, that's 256 possible outcomes. Look at these answer choices. We're clearly barking at the right tree. Now I have to move on to the harder part, which is counting the number of ways, number of possible ways these coin flips can come out so that no 2 adjacent people will stand. Now, how can that happen? Well, if nobody flips heads, then obviously that's going to work out. Just one person flips heads, that's going to be fine too. There won't be 2 people next to each other standing, and that gives us a way to organize our counting. We're going to organize our counting based on the number of heads total that comes up. Now, if there's 0 heads, of course, then no 2 people will be standing next to each other. There's only one way this can happen. There's only one way we can end up with no heads. Now, if there's 1 head, again, if there's 1 head, there's only 1 person standing, so there are no 2 adjacent standing. And there are 8 possible ways we can get 1 head, because each of the 8 people could be the 1 standing. Now, what about 2 heads? Well, now we have to do a little thinking. Of course, there are 8 choose 2 ways that we could pick 2 of these people to end up with heads, but sometimes they're going to be next to each other, so we're going to have to think about this a little bit. There are 2 ways we could go about this. We could go about this by counting all the ways we can have 2 people who aren't adjacent. You could have this person and this person, or this person and this person, or this person and this person. But you know what? I think it's going to be a little bit easier to start with those 8 choose 2 total and subtract off the ones where the 2 are next to each other. That's pretty easy because we can count that really quickly. It could be these 2, or these 2, or these 2, or these 2, all the way around there. 8 pairs next to each other. And we can't have that, so we're going to subtract off the time the 2 heads are these any of these 2 people that are next to each other. So 8 choose 2 is 4 times 7, that's 28. Minus 8 gives us 20 ways we can have 2 people flip heads, but they're not next to each other. So let's move on to 3 heads. Now, we could go with the same strategy. We could start with the 8 choose 3 and then subtract off the ways you have 3 people where at least 2 of them are next to each other. But, well, let's think about that a little bit. You could have these 3, these 3, these 3. That's not so bad. Go all the way around. There's 8 where the 3 are right in a row. We could have these 2 and this 1, or these 2 and this 1, or these 2. That'll work, but sounds like work. Instead, let's think about the number of ways you could have 3 people flip and no 2 of them are adjacent. You could start off with just this one, and this one. And there's just, you know, 1 person between these 2, 1 person between these 2, and then 3 between these 2. Of course, there are 8 configurations like this. There's this one, this one, this one, this one step around, one step around. You get 8 different configurations like that. But this isn't the only way we can end up with 3 heads, no 2 adjacent. Let's take a look. Another group of 8 people. Take this person, and now this person over here. And look at the gaps here. Here's 1, 2, and 2. Here there were 1, 1, and 3. Here the gaps are 1, 2, and 2. And once again, we have 8 possibilities like this. We have this one. Turn it by 1, turn it by 1, turn it by 1. Go all the way around the table. You get 8 more that look just like this. And these are the only 2 ways we can have 3 heads with no 2 adjacent. And if you don't trust me, you can go back and do it the other way. Start with your 8, choose 3, and subtract off, you know, these 3 in a row, or these 2 and this one, these 2 and this one. Go ahead and work it through that way. You should come up with the same thing. Total of 8 in this configuration, 8 in this configuration, 16 ways. You can flip 3 heads, no 2 adjacent. Now off to 4 heads. Now, there's only 2 ways this can work out. We can have these 4, turn it by 1, these 4. Those are the only 2 ways. We can have 4 heads, no 2 adjacent. Well, now I'm running out of room. Fortunately, we don't really have any more cases, because 5 heads, well, there's no way to have 5 heads, no 2 adjacent. And you start off with these 4 and throw in 1 more, it's going to be next to somebody. Same for 6, same for 7, same for 8, everybody's adjacent and standing up. So these are the only ways we can end up with no 2 adjacent people standing. So now we just have to add them up. 2 and 8 gives us 10, add on 20 gives us 30, add the 16 and the 1, that gives us 47. Success is out of 256 possible. There's our answer, and we're done.